Hi, welcome to PrimeTime Pickleball. My name is Jordan Briones, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to hit a side spin return. Let's jump right in. All right, so before we get started, if you're not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe to it and also hit that notification bell icon so that you can be notified every time we release a new video. This really helps us out. All right, so like I said in the beginning of the video, we're gonna jump right in to the side spin return. All right, so this is a return that is going to, after you hit it and as it goes across the net and then it bounces, it's going to stay low to the ground, and also it's going to kick out towards the left of your opponent because of the spin. Okay, this is a right to left motion for me as a righty, and this side spin, this motion here, is what creates that spin. First thing that we're going to start off with is the grip. Okay, so for this shot, you are going to want to use a continental grip. All right, so this is the easiest and best grip for this shot. And the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to get in your ready position here, okay? And you know, this is a good shot for singles and doubles, all right? So I tend to return around this area. And for this video specifically, I'm talking about the forehand. So what you can do is instead of returning here on this side, more to the right side, what I can do is just scoot over and cheat a little bit to leave my forehand more open so I have a better access to this shot. All right, so the first move that I'm going to do, I have my continental grip, is I'm going to turn like this. I'm gonna watch that serve come over, get ready, and I do this initial turn here, okay? And as you can see, my paddle face is open and it's around my shoulder height, okay? And what I'm going to do from here, it's a right to left motion. I'm going to swing down like this, and you can see also that you can see this little L right here, okay? My paddle's not like this. I'm not holding like this. I'm gripping it like with a continental grip, and you can see I go high to low and right to left, okay? And one thing that I want for you guys to notice is that I am not using my wrist and I'm not cutting the ball like this, okay? You're gonna lose a lot of control. The slice comes from this momentum and this motion, and you're going to lead the shot, you're gonna lead with your shoulder, okay? You can see I'm not just using my arm like this. You can see my whole arm and my shoulder go as I hit this ball, all right? So I'm gonna see that serve, get ready, and then I'm going to execute the shot, okay? And you can see, like I said, starts from shoulder, and then I go across my body, contact the ball right around here in front, okay? And then I'm going to end like this. You can see my paddle face is almost directly to the sky. There's gonna be some variance of where you end, but typically it's gonna be like that. The last thing I do wanna mention is, this is not going to be in a closed stance like this or an open stance like this. It's going to be more of this 45 degree angle to the net, and this is a semi-open stance here. And as you can see, as I come here and get ready to swing through the ball, I'm in this semi-open stance, and then I really want my momentum going forward, because after that return, we're crashing the net, right, in doubles, okay? See, and you can see that ball, it really kicks off to the left, towards the backhand of a right-hander, okay? So this is why it's a really good shot. Remember, I'm not cutting it like this. I mean, I'm not like swinging and using my wrist. Everything is leading through my arm, and I'm coming through using my forward momentum coming in, okay? So I can take this cross court or down the line here, okay? Just depending on where I face my paddle. But I usually, for this shot, I kind of like, if they're serving on the even side to even side, I like to go down the line, because it really turns the ball. I think it really manipulates the ball, and I could just aim it right down the line and get this good side spin going. All right, one thing I do want to mention for this shot, this is a really good return for when the ball is really short and low. Okay, a lot of times if your opponent is not really hitting deep serves and you have to step in for the ball, this is a natural shot where you can come in and use your momentum and go in. Okay, when the ball's really deep, it lands really deep, this is probably not the return you want to hit, because it's going to be really tough unless you're going to step back here, right? Because you, in this shot, you really want to be moving forward, and the contact point, you want it kind of low, okay, around knee level, because you can't really, it's hard to get the slice way up here. As you can see, I'm going to have to do this, and the ball can go up and out, okay? I kind of want to contact the ball right around this area and kind of low knee level. So like I said, this is going to be a different look for your opponents. You're not just hitting the ball, hitting a return, and then they're going to have that same ball. This ball is, because of this right to left motion, all right, this ball is going to really, it's going to bend through the air, and as it hits the ground, it's going to kick a little bit to the left. So that means your opponent's third shot, when they get that ball, it's going to be a lot tougher for them to do what they want to do with it. All right, so I hope you enjoyed that. This is another tool that you can add to your toolbox, and as the returner, this is going to put a different look to your opponents, and it's going to be it's going to make their third shot a lot more difficult when you have different spins on the ball. And this is a spin on your forehand side that you can add that's really can mess up the timing of your opponent and the spacing, because they have to now deal with the ball bending to the left. All right, so I hope you like this video. If you did like it, please give it a like, and also share it maybe with a friend, all right? So thanks for joining us in this video, and we'll see you in the next one.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like.
Thanks so much for watching. For more free video lessons, please visit PrimeTimePickleball.com. But before you head on over there, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any future videos. Also, for PrimeTime Pickleball shirts like this and other great apparel, please visit ptpgear.com.